Thanks for tuning in. I'm Nicolas Garfinkel, and in today's demo, we'll be building and deploying a Flask web application to Azure using Azure App Service. By the end of this demo, you should have a good understanding of how you can build your own websites in Azure with Python, and how you can speed up your development cycles leveraging the extensions in Visual Studio Code. The first question is, what is Azure App Service? And it's a fully managed platform for your web applications, so you don't have to deal with setting up or maintaining a web server. Simply put, it handles everything behind the scenes so you can focus on building your website. To follow along, you'll need Visual Studio Code with the Python extension, as well as the Azure App Service and Azure Cosmos DB extension. You'll also need an Azure subscription in Python 3. So the first thing we're going to do is deploy a Hello World Flask application. I'm going to start by cloning the sample application from the Azure Samples repo. Pro tip, there are over 100 different Python samples in there for you to play around with. Once it's done cloned, we can go ahead and cd into the folder, and by typing code dot, we're going to open up Visual Studio Code into this specific directory. The first thing I like to do with any project is create a virtual environment so I can isolate my package dependencies from my global environment. With my virtual environment now created and activated, I'll go ahead and run pip install requirement.txt so we can install the packages we need for this specific project. When it comes to Flask or Django apps, we can quickly create a debug file to tell VS Code how the debugger should run. To do that, click on a Python file, navigate over to the debugger screen, and go ahead and follow the prompts for our Flask application, and renaming our main file to match the file in our program, application.py. If I hit F5, I can start my app in debugger mode, which lets me run the Flask application locally. And if I go ahead and open that up in a browser, I can see the screen pulls up exactly what I'm expecting. Now let's deploy the app to Azure App Service. We'll navigate over to the Azure icon, go to the App Service section, and start the deployment process. First, it'll ask me to give it a globally unique name. This name will end up being the URL for our application. Next, we select the runtime. I'm using 3.6, so I'll use 3.6 in my application as well. What's happening here is it's creating an app service app plan for us so we can host our app. This will take about 10-20 seconds, but I'm going to go ahead and edit this part out. So the process just finished, and what I'm going to do now is actually deploy to the new app that I have. So again, I'll choose the folder. Now I just wait. I've edited out the deployment wait time, but our site is now live on Azure and accessible by anyone in the world. And if I pull up the URL, I'll get the expected string. And like the old adage, if a tree falls in a forest, if you're not viewing your website logs, does it even exist? Let's explore how we can view these logs directly from VS Code. There's two ways we can do it. First, let's right-click on our application and start our streaming logs. Immediately, you should start seeing it initialize. Now, when I visit my website, the logs should show up directly in VS Code. And each time I visit my website, a new entry in my log gets placed directly in my terminal. And to stop it, it's simply just right-click the icon again and go to Stop Streaming Log. Another way you can view your logs is by doing it directly in the Azure portal. To navigate to the resource, go ahead and right-click your app again and click Open in Portal. This will go ahead and actually pull up your exact resource so you don't spend time trying to navigate to it. If I head over to Diagnose and Solve Problem, I can click through to Availability and Performance, and eventually Application Logs. In application logs, I can see all my logs for my application to understand what's going on and what errors I might be running into. Back to our Flask application, I've gone ahead and redeployed it, this time including a pandas module without including it in the requirements.txt file. As we expected, the website broke, and I'd like to show you quickly what the logs look like for a situation like this. If we scroll through the logs, we can see down here it says that the module is not found, and that quickly tells me what I need to go fix. If I simply go back to my web app, go to the requirements.txt, and include pandas down here, it'll now work when I redeploy. Now let's move on to a more interesting example. We'll deploy a Flask web application with reach from Cosmos database. The code is pretty simple. Whenever someone visits the root, I'll query the database for my record ID and return that value. I'm using the new Azure Python SDK to communicate with Cosmos DB and setting environment variables to store the secret keys securely. The first thing you'll need to do is create a Cosmos database and insert your first record. We can do all of that inside our IDE without ever having to navigate any portals. Nope, one, two, three. If you're following along, the first thing you need to do is create a Cosmos database and insert your first record. We can do all of that inside our IDE by simply navigating back over through the Azure extension and heading over to the Cosmos database section. We can follow the prompts here to create an account. To save us some time, I've already created the account in advance. And if I double click our first record, we can see here that Nicholas' favorite foods are blueberries, peanut butter, and spinach. I can also right click my Cosmos database account and do things like copy the connection string directly into my IDE. Next, I need to update my environment variables. Environment variables allow us to store sensitive information like secret keys. We don't want hard-coded into our code. It's one of the more secure ways to handle these things. I can interact with them directly from the Azure extension by navigating to our app service app, expanding the tree, and downloading the remote settings. As you can see, these are the ones that are currently in my application. And if I navigate back over to the .env file, I can start creating some of these values we need for Cosmos. Now let's add the environment variables we're using in the application.py file. The first one is Cosmos key. And the second one we need is the Cosmos URL. Now, if you remember, I copied the connection string to our Cosmos database before. And so I can go ahead and just use these values now and plug them into my application settings. Now, these values are sensitive, but I am deleting these resources afterwards, so I'm not too concerned about showing you the key. Finally, we go back, we save, go back to the application settings, and now we can upload our local settings. And when we do this, it's going to include the two new values that we added. Now we're really close to getting this deployed, and the last thing we need to do is update our requirement.txt file to account for the new Azure Python SDK we're importing into our Flask application. The new SDK allows me to query the Cosmos database with just a few lines of code. Now let's add it to the requirements.txt. If you're unsure of what the version number is, you could always add the package without that, but it's highly recommended that you include it so there's no breaking changes in the future. So that's it. Now let's go and deploy the application. We'll head back over to the Azure icon, right-click our application, and start the deployment process. To save everyone some time, I edited out the deployment wait, but now that it's done, I can go ahead here and right-click Browse to Website. And as you can see, my web app returns the values that I would expect from my Cosmos database. And that's our demo for today. Thank you so much for joining. I had a blast putting this all together for you. If you're interested in learning more, check out that Getting Started link, aka.ms/py20webstart. I also linked the GitHub repo if you want to pick up where I left off. Or if you have any problems with your Python and app service experience, for a limited time, check out that final link. I'd love to learn more about your problem and see if we can help you work through it.